Hello everyone, my name is Pathan Huzaif, Assistant Professor of Shreeyash of Pharmacy, Aurangabad. So in last video lecture of Pharmacodynamics Part 1, we have learned about concept of pharmacodynamics, site and types of drug action, various mechanism of drug actions, various receptor families, we have seen that, dose and their therapeutic index and their tolerance of the drugs. So in a second part of pharmacodynamics, we are learn about factor modifying the effects of the drug. So let's we start. जैसा कि हमें पता है कि अलग-अलग patients में various patients having various responses against the drugs. अलग-अलग patient में अलग-अलग responses दिखाई देते हैं हमें drugs के. In that variation in responses to the same dose of a drug between the different patients, even in the same patients on a different occasion. Same patient में भी अलग-अलग आपको जो तो उसके different occasions दिखाई देंगे, different उसके effects दिखाई देंगे. Different patient में same drug कभी देते हैं हम 10 milligram. तो वो different patients में because of their physiological condition, their pathological condition, their disease condition, बहुत सारे factors हैं जो हम next इसमें देखने वाले, next slide में देखने वाले. बहुत सारे factors हैं जो affect करते हैं drug response को. So which are the factors affecting the drug responses or modifying the effects of drugs? So we see that these factors modifying the drug action either quantitatively or qualitatively. These are the major factors. The plasma, in that the plasma concentration of or drug action is increases or decreases. In that the plasma concentration kabhi badhta hai ya kam ho sakta hai. Qualitatively, the types of responses is altered due to the disease condition. For example, drug allergy, idiosyncrasy, hypertension, diabetic mellitus, that conditions. The drug effect is modified or changes. First, if the various factors are, the first factor is the body weight. So it influences the concentration of drug attained at the site of the actions. The average adult dose refers to the individual of the medium build. So these are the for in the children. हमें पता है कि different weights होते हैं. Childrens में अलग weight दिखेंगे आपको. Adult patients में अलग-अलग weights दिखाई देते हैं. Adult patient में अलग-अलग weight दिखाई देते हैं. So generally जो medicines बनाई जाती है वो adult patients के लिए बनाई जाती है, but आपको कभी कोई dose childrens के लिए लेना है तो वो calculate करना पड़ेगा आपको. So with the help of these are formulas. ये दो formulas है, individual dose is equal to body weight in kilogram upon 70 into average adult dose. Now the second formula is individual dose equal to BSA. BSA means what? Body surface area in meter square upon 1.7 into average adult dose. So this is the formula for the children. Next factor is age. Age for infants and children, the dose of drug for children is often calculated from the adult dose. Adult dose hota hai. हमने पहले बताया कि adult dose से जो थे child का dose, elder patients का dose, old patient का dose calculate किया जाता है. With the help of this Young's formula and Dillings formula. These are the two formula using for the infants and children dose calculations. Elder patients. So some factors of elder patients having the, we are now what the elder patients having the some so much the care for this disease conditions. So that it is disease condition modifying the drug actions. For example, chronic disease states, use of the multiple medications in the elder patients, decreases plasma protein binding in elder patient, slow metabolism, slow excretion, dietary deficiencies and lack of complications. So these are the factors which affects the modifying or affects the drug action in the elder patients. Next is gender. The females have the smaller body size and so required the dose of drugs on the lower side of dose range. They should not be given uterine stimulant during the menstruations, quinine during the pregnancy and sedatives during the lactation. Next, fourth is a pregnancy. So profound physiological changes which may affect the drug responses. For example, GI motility reduces at this condition, plasma and extracerebrospinal fluid volume expanded, albumin level falls, renal blood flow increases markedly, hepatic microsomal enzymes inductions is induced in a pregnancy condition. So this effects will modify the drug action. Next is the food. We know about the food increases or decreases drug action. For example, delay gastric emptying, delay absorptions, calcium in a milk interferes with absorption of tetracycline and iron by chelation, protein malnutrition will affect on the drug activities. Next is a species and race. Various species will affect on the drug action. For example, rabbit resistant atropine, rat and mice are resistant to digitalase. In human, blacks requires a higher, mongols required low concentration of atropine and ephedrine to dilate their pupils. So these are the species and race which affect on the drug effect. Routes of drug administration. We know about the IV or parenteral drug administration. It is the best route of administration because it's having the higher therapeutic index. For example, magnesium sulfate we get orally, purgatives, parenterally as sedatives, and locally to reduce inflammation. So one drug having the various physiological changes or physiological action, therapeutic drug efficacies are there. Next is chronopharmacology. We know about the chronopharmacology. Chrono means what? It is a physiological time, it is a time, biological time of your bodies. So various time of your bodies react various conditions. So for example, hypnotics given by taken at night, corticosteroids taken at a single morning dose. Various psychological states, efficacy of a drugs can be affected by a patient beliefs, attitudes and their expectations. For example, particularly applicable to centrally acting drugs, some placebo therapy also used for this. Presence of disease and pathological states. Humne pehle bataya ki presence of disease and pathological states will affect on the patients, their acceptance tendency, or there are decreases or increases drug effect. For example, drug metabolism, in hyperthyroidism, drug effects is enhances or metabolism is enhances of drugs. In hyperthyroidism, drug metabolism is decreases. So disease condition or pathological condition will affect on the drug effects. Genetic factors, some genetic factors also involving in drug effects. For example, lower metabolic rate, acetylation, plasma cholinesterase, G6PD and glucuronide conjugation will affect on the drug actions. Next is a tolerance. It means requirement of a drugs, higher dose of drugs to produce an effects which is ordinarily produced by normal therapeutic dose of a drugs. Drug tolerance may be natural bhi ho sakta hai, acquired bhi ho sakta hai, cross tolerance bhi ho sakta hai, tachyphylaxis bhi ho sakta hai. For the ephedrine, taramine and nicotine drugs and drug resistance also there. So this is all about the factor modifying the drug actions. So bahut sare factors humne dekhe. So this is the second part of pharmacodynamics. Thank you.